Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie.
This morning's topic:
damaged but repairable. Then I went down to the potter's house, and behold, he wrought a work on the wheels, and the vessel that was made of clay was marred in the hand of the potter. So he made it again, another vessel, as it seemed good to the potter to make it. Then the word of the Lord came to me, saying, O house of Israel, cannot I do with you as this potter, saith the Lord? Behold, as the clay is in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. Jeremiah 18:3-6. We're brought up in a society that demands nothing but the best from us. We go to school, we expect to get the best grades. Finish school, we expect to get the best job. Get married, have a white picket fence and a perfect family. And if these things don't happen, we tend to be looked on as being failures, sometimes viewed as outcasts, if we miss the mark that is set for us. However, while God calls us to be perfect and to be holy, this is a process. The Bible is riddled with men and women of God who are called by God, but yet had struggles within their flesh. Adam had no backbone. Noah was an alcoholic. Moses was a murderer. David committed adultery. Gideon was afraid. Peter was brash and loved to talk. Now, these are all men who were called by God. However, they had struggles. Sometimes it would appear that God is not as hard on us when we make mistakes as people will be. Sometimes, long after God has forgiven us, people still think it's cool to punish us, hold us off, keep us bound. We live in a disposable society. And so as a car gets right off, you buy a new one. TV not working, you buy a new one. Computer won't start up, what, you get a new one. Sadly, the wife is too nagging, well, you get a new one. Husband lost his job, well, you get the gist. Israel was called and chosen by God to be God's beacon in the earth. However, they missed the mark. God wanted to illustrate to Jeremiah that though Israel was broken, they still could be repaired. And so Jeremiah took a stroll to the potter's house. He saw vessels that were once whole, but now they were broken. But the potter did not throw the vessels away, no. But the potter took them and began to do a work, repairing them, remolding them, restoring that which was damaged. Their sisters were told that he loved you and that you're going to be his future wife, only to find out that you were only one of the candidates. And so you have your heart broken. Many persons in ministry don't feel appreciated by those who they pastor, and it leaves them broken on the inside. Many of you have been on the job and doing the work, but being overlooked for the promotion. All of these things can leave you damaged. Can I tell the child of God that you may be a damaged vessel, but God is getting ready to put you back on the potter's wheel. He's about to remold you. He's about to reshape you. He's about to reform you. He's going to make you better than you ever been. You are filled with hurt and pain, but if you allow God, he can pick you up and transform you into a new vessel. I say to you today, you may be damaged, but you are repairable. The quote of the day: you might live in a disposable society, but you've got a God who loves to repair. As you go today, go knowing that though you're a damaged vessel, God did not throw that old vessel away. God bless you, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.